least 150 students here today from close to 60 different schools, and I have some of the students have traveled over 4 hours to get here today, so we truly appreciate that. Some people that I need to thank, right away I need to thank our music faculty at St. Norbert, especially need to thank our music staff and student workers, the band staff and students who were here this morning. As a matter of fact, we were here with a lot of students last night, rather late trying to set this up. Some of the students were here very, very early this morning, trying to continue to set things up and put things on the stands they belong. And I've got a crew that's going to be here deep into the evening, I think, trying to get this set for our concerts tomorrow and Monday. So a lot of appreciation goes to those people. And also, you always have to thank people who are responsible for the musical progress of these students. First of all, I think we as a band right now, myself included, we need to thank the parents and relatives that are out there. Can we do that please right now? Thanks to your support that they can attend clinics such as this. Also, we have a large number of directors who are responsible for the students up here today. I would really like to have those directors, please, if you're here, or in general, if you're a band director someplace, choir director, music teacher, will you stand right now and be recognized, please? Stand up. There we go. Those are many of the people that help keep the arts alive. We truly appreciate that. I also have to thank, right now, we've had a couple of our instructors who this morning in particular spent their entire time in the percussion section, and I want you to know that once you get into the percussion section in this setup, you're there for the day. There's no way to get out of there because they're locked in back there. And Carter Bolt and Tim Johnson were here, I know, most of the morning, I believe, and into the afternoon. I want to thank them. And there's another young lady that every year I keep saying, you know what, I need to thank you, because she first of all was one of those directors that was on the committee that helped me start this. Her name is Connie Kramer. She's the band director at Lena. Connie also, every year, works with the percussion. And she was here once again today, all day, back in the percussion section. And I've always kept thinking, you know, I've got to do more than just thank her. Or maybe once in a while, maybe I've actually thanked her, written her a note thanking her. But I need to do more than that, because once again today, she was back there. And she's really back there today as a percussion clinician. She's still back on stage. I don't think we've let her off stage all day. How do you thank someone like this other than doing it publicly? Well, the next best thing is you find a St. Norbert College pep band shirt to give to this band director. Can we all please, now there's no way that I can bring her forward right now. I don't think she can make it. But can we please show some appreciation? Can you at least wave back there, Connie? Can we please thank her? Teaching in the public schools outside of Phoenix, Arizona. You can read about all the awards that he's garnered over the years, all the recognition, and well-deserved. I didn't really know Doug until we've been communicating back and forth, and he was highly recommended to me this year. He's doing, I believe, at least one of his compositions, and also doing some compositions from some other composers, and truly have enjoyed having him work with us today, and would like to have you please, and he told me, by the way, he knew that it was going to be cold here. He also told me that it was cold where he was from, because Phoenix yesterday was cold. It was 80 degrees cold in Phoenix. We feel sorry for him, I'm sure. Would like to right now ask for you to help me give Doug a warm Wisconsin welcome. This is your clinician, Doug Hickey.
based on a Korean folk song called Ahirang. If you've ever been to Korea, you hear this folk song constantly. It's almost like the second national hymn or something. And many of you will recognize it. It's been used in a number of different band works. This particular setting is very chorale-like, very smooth. And one of the very first things we started working on this morning was learning not just to play the break notes and rhythms, but how to connect those notes so that they flow one into the other and make some kind of a musical sentence. It sounds like a very simple thing to do, and yet when you try to do it on a musical instrument, it's quite a challenge, but I think we've come a long ways today. And if you pay attention to that and listen to the smoothness, and if we keep the air and the sound flowing, then you'll know how good a job we've done on this, working on it today. I teach junior high, and I've been doing it for 16 years. That's not as long as some, but it's longer than most people make it in a junior high school. Or it's taking me longer to get out of junior high than most people, or I don't know how you figure that. And once a week I have to go out into the general population outside my band room and do hall duty. And I see what most junior high students are like. And then I realize how wonderful it is to have students involved in a music program. Certainly fine students, honor students such as these who excel at it. We had 4.5 hours of rehearsal today, and And not once did I have to ask somebody to be quiet or to pay attention. It was just very simple. Now, it's probably not that easy at home. And I don't know exactly why it happens, but all I know is that I really appreciate not only the attention and the maturity of these students, but I certainly appreciate the music programs back at their schools that nurture that kind of mature attitude that's going to serve these young people very well when they go on into life. They aren't all going to become professional musicians. As a matter of fact, very few of them will. Let's hope, or the rest of us will be out of business because there's a lot of talented people on the stage here. But regardless of what they go into, the skills that they use working together here, listening, following directions, being leaders within their groups, and the social interaction are really very valuable skills, and I'm pleased to see that happen so strongly in this part of Wisconsin. I get to travel around the country, and I'm always amazed at how the music students stand out from the general populations of students that I often encounter. So I do want to compliment them in that respect, and this has been a very wonderful day. We've made some excellent music. We're going to finish our program with the third of four pieces that we worked on today. The fourth piece, very exciting and wonderful work, but it just requires a little more than 4.5 hours that we had to put into it. And rather than present you with something that was half-baked, we thought we'd just give you the loaves that were completely done, and we'll leave the others, do them some other time, perhaps. The last piece that we are going to do today is called Canto. Some of you have probably heard this piece before. It's by Dr. Francis Macbeth from the University of Arkansas. Dr. Macbeth spends a lot of time in Japan. He conducts Kosai Wind Ensemble, which is sponsored by Sony, if I'm not mistaken. Very, very fine, top-notch musical organization. And in his travels and his stays in Japan, he's been fascinated by Japanese music. Japanese music is very different from Western music or music that we have here in Europe or America, in that instead of melody being the most important thing, you've all heard, you know, well, that's a melody you can whistle. Well, you can't whistle Japanese melodies. Frankly, they're not that memorable, but it's the beat. It's the rhythm, it's the percussion that cause the excitement, and that's the point of interest. So as we play canto, even as you hear melodic instruments playing, listen to the rhythms they're playing, how they interact, and I think a lot of the rhythms will be very obvious. And if you focus on that, you'll start to appreciate the Japanese music. This piece was written years ago for an all-state band, and it's been a standard in the repertoire ever since, and I think when you hear it, you'll understand why it's such a wonderful piece. I thank you all for coming this evening, and I thank these students for the opportunity to work with them, and we hope you enjoy our last piece, Canto.